In this tutorial, I will show you how to buy and install WordPress on GreenGeeks step by step, where I will show you which hosting plan you should choose and the actual buying process involved. I will then show you how to install WordPress on GreenGeeks the right way and choosing the correct settings. Towards the end of this video, I will give you a very special offer if you decide to pick up GreenGeeks through my link below. I will give you my six-figure blogger course for free as a way of saying thank you for supporting my channel. Now let's get started. Step one, click on the link in the description or type this into your browser. It'll take you to my special GreenGeeks discount page where you will get the best discount GreenGeeks is currently offering. Full transparency, this is an affiliate link. I will receive a small commission while you get a special discount and my six-figure blogger course for free. So it can be a win-win situation for the both of us, and I really appreciate you supporting my channel. Now we click on Get Started Now. Now, GreenGeeks has three shared hosting plans for you to choose from. The first is the Lite plan. This one will only allow you to have one website, so it's going to be suitable for you if you're a local business or you're someone who only needs one website. But if you want any more than that, you're going to need to go for the Pro plan or the Premium plan. Now, both of them offer unlimited websites, but the main difference here is the performance and the IP address. So the Pro plan only gives you a 2x performance increase from the Lite plan, but the Premium plan is even faster at 4x. And the other main difference is you get a free dedicated IP address. So unless you really need it for a specific project, then I definitely recommend you just take the Pro plan, as this will be more than enough for your multiple websites. And not having a dedicated IP address will not affect your SEO and will still allow you to rank your websites fine. I don't use a dedicated IP address for my beginner websites and they are still ranking fine. So I'm going to click on Get Started on the Pro plan. Now, when it comes to domain names, I recommend you don't buy any of your domain names from any hosting providers. Other YouTubers don't tell you this and it really annoys me, so I'm going to explain it to you now. For example here, a .com domain name from GreenGeeks is going to cost you $13.95 per year, but you're going to have to pay an extra $9.95 for the domain privacy. Domain privacy is very important, and I believe this is a requirement as it protects you from marketers contacting you constantly every day trying to sell their services to you. So overall, it's going to cost about $24 per year for a .com domain from GreenGeeks. But if you go to a dedicated domain name provider like Namecheap, which I use myself, it's only going to cost you $8.88 per year, and they provide you the domain privacy for free. So you think about it, $9 as opposed to $24, that's about 3x cheaper, and that's every year. So if you want to save money in the long term, then I recommend you go for Namecheap. But if you just want the easiest way and you have the budget, then you can choose GreenGeeks. And if it's GreenGeeks, then you just type in the new domain you want here. But if it's my recommended method from Namecheap, then you buy it from Namecheap, and I have a video to guide you through that step by step here. And then you come down here and type in your domain name that you've chosen. Now click on next, and now you can see your coupon savings has been applied and you've got the discount from my link. Now you fill out your private information here. Now the next thing is to choose how long you want to buy your hosting plan for. And obviously 3 years is going to be the cheapest. So I recommend you always buy the longest plan possible, as when it comes time to renewing, they're going to charge you a lot more. So pick the 3-year plan and play around with it. And if you're happy with it, keep it. But if you're not, then you have a 30-day money back guarantee where they will refund you the full cost. But just be aware that if you do buy your domain name from GreenGeeks, that part cannot be refunded. So now with the server location, you can choose where you want to host your website, and they have 3 locations. So what I recommend you do is to choose a server location which is closest to most of your visitors. So if it is a global site, then I recommend you choose United States. But if it's anywhere in Europe or even in Asia, it may be better to choose Europe as it's closer to you. But I'll select United States for this tutorial. And now fill in your payment information and click on Create Account. and that's it, your order is successful. Now you will need to follow their instructions and go and check your email for the login details. So here's my login credentials and the login page, click on that. Now enter in your login details. Verify everything. You may need to verify by sending the code. So I've sent the code. And now I'm going to check my email and put the code in. And here is my code. Now I click on verify code. So now my account has been verified and I'm logged in. We are now logged into Green Geek's dashboard. And before we do anything further, the next step is to connect your domain name from Namecheap to Green Geek's. But if you bought your domain name from Green Geek's, then just skip this step and go right to the next one. But if you got it from Namecheap like me, then go to Hosting, click on Manage, and see here Domain Name Servers. These are the three name servers we need to copy over to our Namecheap hosting account for our selected domain name. So this is a domain that I want to connect to Green Geek's on my Namecheap account. So you come down to the name server section and you select this and change it to custom DNS. Then for the name server 1, 2, and 3, this is where you would paste in those values from Green Geek's. And now that they have copied in, you just click on the check mark here and save it. That's it. It says your DNS server has been updated and may take 48 hours. This is rarely the case, normally an hour max, but 5 to 10 minutes and it should be ready. So when it's ready, we can go to our next step. We are now ready to install our WordPress website. And to do this, click on hosting and click on cPanel. And now just a quick side note, if you want to install your second, third or fourth websites, then you just click on this add-on domains button and add your domain first before you can install your WordPress website. But anyway, this is my first website and the domain name has already been added on checkout. So we scroll down to the WordPress Manager by Softaculous, click on that. And now we just click on install. Make sure you pick the right domain name, type in your site name and the site description. Now we scroll down to the admin account. And for the username, make sure to use anything but admin, because when people try to hack your website, they're gonna guess admin first. And for your password, I recommend you put in something safe. I normally just let Softaculous generate me a new password. And for the admin email, put an email in that you want to use. Now we scroll down and you can untick WP Forms as you may not need it, but Lightspeed Cache is a really handy plugin to have as it'll speed up your website a lot. So we can keep that there for now. And we can scroll down to the bottom and click on install. And that's it. Your WordPress website has been installed successfully, but we can't open these pages yet because our SSL certificate is not being installed and our website is not yet secured. We still have another step to go, but I just wanted to quickly ask if you're getting value out of my channel. If so, just hit that like button for me and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on any quality content that I release every single week. So the next step is to install our SSL certificate. So from the dashboard, we want to go to security, click on add SSL certificate, select your service, pick your domain name, click continue, and we want to select the free Let's Encrypt SSL. That is enough. And now click on confirm and create. Now we want to install our SSL certificate. And that's it. Our SSL certificate has now been installed. So to check that it all worked, we want to go back into our Softaculous app and log in and check. So we click on Softaculous here, click on installations, and we want to click on admin here. And here it is. This is our WordPress dashboard page. So this means that it's been installed correctly and the site lock here is active, which means that our SSL certificate is working. And also to check the front end of the website, we scroll over here and click on visit site. And this also shows our bare bones website is working and our site is locked. Now the next step is to create our email address. So to do this, we go back to our dashboard, click on cPanel, and we scroll down to the email accounts section. Click on that and click on create. Choose your username and password, and now we want to click on create. And it's that simple. You can see my email has been successfully created also. Just a quick note on my bonus offer to you. If you decide to pick up Green Geeks through my link, then just send me your receipt to bonus@dotcomdollar.com and I'll send you access to my bonus course right away. It's that simple. Now that you have successfully installed WordPress onto your bare bones Green Geeks account, it's time to go out and actually fully build out your website. And this next video will help you do just that. So check it out and I'll see you in that next tutorial.